and you are all very welcome along to a brand new season of the Champ.ie Horse Racing Podcast. Back with you for another 6 months from November to April, the Champ.ie Horse Racing Podcast is proud to be entering a fifth winter jumps campaign. Coming up on this episode, the lads look ahead to this weekend's big racing from Down Royal, AINTREE and Wincanton. Also coming up, Barry speaks with special guest Henry De Bromhead about big race entries this weekend and plans for some of the stable stars for this season. We are also delighted to announce that this season, the Champ.ie Horse Racing Podcast will be brought to you in association with Boylesports, Gowran Park Racecourse and Syndicates.racing. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel as it helps to get racing content out there to the wider audience. Sit back, get yourself a coffee, and enjoy the show.
Boylesports. Don't just bet, choose wisely.
So, hello and welcome back to the Champ.ie podcast. Mr. Groome has joined me for episode one of season number five, Ron. It's hard to believe we're entering our fifth jumps campaign, and we're starting by looking ahead to Down Royal this weekend.
Very much so. Yeah, great to be back. Great to be back in it and chatting racing again and jumps action really getting going now. Obviously, we did Charlie Hall last week and we have the rescheduled Down Royal meeting this week. Jerry Colomb going to strut his stuff up in Down Royal. So it's really, we're really getting into the thick of it now. So it's great to be back on talking about it, yeah.
100%. We've 6 months of it running, 57, I believe, streams scheduled. And as you can see down below, we've got some new partners as well, and we have to discuss that, Ronan, because we partnered up with Gowran Park Racecourse, Syndicates Racing, Jack Canton on a course, and the guys there, and Boylesports, Sarah May, the betting partner. So great to have some new partners on board and some exciting stuff to share with Champ.ie listeners right throughout the season. 57 streams, Ronan Groome. You'll be tired at the end.
No, it's always enjoyable to come on and chat with you, Basil, as you know well. And look, fair play to you. You've been beavering away through the summer, signing these mega million deals to get these big name associations with Syndicates that racing in Gowran Park. And obviously great to have Boyles on with us again, of course, with all the prices and such. So, yeah, it's brilliant. Great to be associated with these people. So, yeah, looking forward to it.
Yeah, 100%. Just to signpost it, Ronan, because obviously last season we had the Cheltenham show and we'll be doing the same again. That's kicking off. Can you believe it? The first episode of the Road to Cheltenham Challenge is on Monday upcoming. So we need to get your first AntePost selection for the Cheltenham Festival. We'll leave that for next week. And of course, Thursday shows right up until the end of April. So November to April, 6 months of it in association with our proud sponsors down below, Gowran Park Racecourse and Syndicates Racing, and Boylesports is the betting partner. So just a word on the new partners, Ronan, because before we rattle into the racing, Syndicates Racing will start with Jack Canton and the guys. Obviously, look, I think we've been searching for the perfect racing syndicate to get involved with for quite a while. And for me, I just think the options available, look at the trainers obviously involved here, Willie Mullins, Henry De Bromhead, Gordon Elliott, to name just a few, John McConnell, obviously, and Gavin Cromwell. And they've had big winners, obviously, Grand G, Cabaret Queen. They'll get you to the big days. And what I like about it is the options available. Share starting at like the likes of €200. For me, you can get involved at a very good level with Syndicates Racing, you know, at a very good level, obviously, for very affordable prices. So I think for any, especially for our listeners, I think we can offer a lot now. You can get, as a Champ.ie listener, the Champ.ie exclusive follower discount. So you can get €50 off your first share. Obviously, the link will be in the description. You can visit syndicates.racing themselves and obviously choose your horse, whether it be Willie Mullins, Gordon Elliott, Henry De Bromhead. And we'll hear from Henry De Bromhead on the show. He is our special guest this week, building up to Down Royal. But Ronan, lots of options, and that's what I like. Obviously, you can get involved with Syndicates Racing and get to the big days for very affordable prices.
Absolutely. And look, Syndicates that Racing is something that I've followed right from the start. I believe that I spoke to Jack Cantlin. I did a big interview with him. God, it must be 4 years ago now, I suppose, just when Cabaret Queen had won the Munster National and she'd bolted up there. And that's really got Syndicates that Racing got going, and it's just grown and grown and grown. And now they have a myriad of horses you can get involved in for cheap very cheap prices and have the ownership experience. And look, Syndicates mightn't be for everyone, but they are very popular with people who just want to get in and see how things work and go racing and see the feedback from the trainer and the jockey. And I think it's brilliant. It's the way we should be getting people into the sport. And obviously some people then they want to go on, or the Syndicate is enough for them and they love that experience. And some people go and they go and buy their own horses, or they get their own partnerships going or their own syndicates going. And but they have the gateway through to the sport via Syndicates that racing and via
Syndicates. I did say to Jack Rowland that obviously they've had a Punchestown Festival winner, they've had a Dublin Racing Festival winner. Maybe it could be the lucky charm, the Champ.ie lucky charm. Maybe this year could be the year. Could be a good time to get involved. And maybe we could see a Cheltenham winner. But we'll have to look, there's lots more on that. We've lots to get through. And we'll be hearing, hopefully, we're going to get Jack Cantillon on the show next week. And obviously, we're building up to the November meeting at the at Cheltenham. And well, who knows, he might have an interesting runner next week as well. So we'll be hearing from Jack. We're going to get him on the show to talk to you the catalogue. And Mike Vince, of course, had a share in Cabaret Queen. We're going to get the full band back together next week in terms of the podcast. But me and Ronan for this week, you'll have to suffer us. Gowran Park, just a quick mention. We're going to do 3 live morning line shows, Ronan, down in Gowran for their big days. Obviously, Thyestes Chase Day. Also, Thyestes Chase Day, obviously, we have to mention Red Mills Day as well. That's on the 17th of February, a Saturday, and Shamrock Chase Day. But a big thank you to Eddie Scally and the guys down there. We can't wait to be down on track on those big days. Obviously, Thyestes Day, the 25th, Thursday, the 25th, the race that stops the county run, Groome, the 25th of January, that is. And yeah, absolutely can't wait for that.
Absolutely. It'd be great to go down on track. And I'm sure we might be able to hook a few jockeys and trainers in for the preview and have a chat with them. I've never been to the Thyestes, believe it or not. Been to Gowran Park plenty of times, but I heard plenty about how good a day the Thyestes is. So very much looking forward to that. Yeah, that should be great.
Gowran Park Racecourse, the premier racetrack in the southeast of Ireland, is located on the outskirts of Kilkenny City. Gowran is your number one choice for corporate days out, stag and hen party events, and an overall great local racing experience. Known as the race that stops the county, the famous Goffs Thyestes Chase 2024 takes place on Thursday, the 25th of January.
In the finish of the Goffs Thyestes, invitation only, and Ruby Walsh on the near side for Willie Mullins' 7th win in the race. Invitation only has beaten Alphonse Obus.
With packed crowds expected once again this January, you can book your early bird tickets online today. Visit gowranpark.ie online, click the link in the Champ.ie podcast video description, or scan the QR code on screen to purchase right now. Eddie and the team look forward to welcoming you all to Gowran Park Racecourse this winter.
We absolutely cannot wait. You'll see, obviously, the link in the description for early bird tickets. And look forward to getting Eddie Skelly on the show as well very, very soon. Ronan, it's about time we get into it. The five cast up on screen. You will see the five races that we're going to get involved in. And we're going to change that. So we're going to do a monthly VIP draw. So to qualify, you must have post your five cast selections. Obviously, there's 4 weeks in the month typically, but we're going to run a VIP draw at the end of every month, and to qualify you must post your selections every week and have 2 winners or more to qualify. And I do believe our first draw will be on the 30th of November. Ronan, let's get into it. Let's talk racing. And the first race we're going to look at this week is the big one at Down Royal on Saturday. Obviously we'll be racing tomorrow as we're recording, but let's talk about the champion chase last year, Envoi Allen. I think it was Grenadine and Envoi Allen was a double last season that we put up on the podcast, and you told me it was insane doing the double. I can't remember the price, but Envoi Allen goes well fresh. He was disappointing on his reappearance and has his stablemate to face up against and Jerry Calam here.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, you love remembering those little wins you had last season. It's a pity you don't remember all the times I put these horses up that I managed to win. But look, yeah, look, it's only 4 runners, but an intriguing contest. Obviously, we've got the 2 from Gordon's and the 2 from Henry's. Envoi Allen is what I worry about, is the pattern has been broken here, as in for the last 4 seasons, he's arrived in Down Royal and won first time up. And this time they decided to run him at Gowran, obviously, and he's been beaten. He's been disappointing. So I don't know. The alarm bells have rang plenty of times during this horse's career for me, and he keeps coming back. But I'd just be slightly worried about that. It'd be in the back of my mind. Gerry Cologne, obviously, I'm a huge fan of him. I really think he should be a four-time Grade 1 winning novice chaser. I think he should have won at the Cheltenham Festival. I'm not hugely critical of the ride he got. I just thought if he got a going a fraction earlier, he would have caught the real whacker and won, and then he showed just how good he was over the entry, albeit not beating as strong a field there. For me, he's got the class. He's a Grade 1 winner at 2.5 miles and 3 miles. So he's got the speed, he's got the class, but he's going to stay. But just because I think he's a real Gold Cup horse doesn't really mean I think I should be all over him on Saturday. And I think if there's a way into this race, it's with his stablemate Conflated. I wouldn't write him off after his seasonal debut. Gordon said he'd only been back in a few weeks, if I recall correctly. He travelled well through that race, jumped well, and he just kind of just faded away in the straight. But we're dealing with a horse here who was third to Brave Man's Game and galloping the Champ in the Gold Cup, and I think that's the best recent form on offer here. I think he's perennially kind of underrated, Conflated, because of where he came from. He came through the handicap chase route, and all of a sudden he won that race, the Savills Chase, or the Irish Gold Cup, kind of as an outsider. But he has really developed into a Grade 1 horse since, and that run in the Gold Cup, when Sam Ewing had to come in and ride him, that was a huge run. I would be willing to give him the benefit of the doubt, stick to Gordon's word that run at Punchestown was just a pipe opener completely. He hadn't been back in work, and I think he'll strip a lot fitter here, and I'd be willing to take a chance on him. I think he'll be a slightly bigger price come Friday evening, maybe around 6-1 mark, something like that. That'd be my way into race. Just to give a quick mention to Minella Indo as well, and obviously he'll come in, but I'm not completely sure that he can put two good runs together now. I think he's been a bit fragile the last few years, and I just need to see a bit more to conclude that he's not on the complete regressive streak. So I'd be willing to take him on here as well. And I think Gerry Cologne long term, I think, is the best Gold Cup hope out of these, but I think Conflated could have his day on Saturday.
Yes, and one thing to mention, obviously, Envoi Allen coming into the race last year with the fresh angle was key. He's obviously had a run, but we'll hear from Henry De Bromhead later on in the show. He was disappointed with that run, but does believe he's in good form coming into the race. And for me, he's, the second youngest in the race. Obviously, we have the 10-year-old in here, which is Minella Indo, and I think you're absolutely right about the putting two runs back-to-back. Especially at the age of 10 now as well. It's maybe a slight concern. Gerry Cologne, if he had won at the Cheltenham Festival, he would have been unbeaten. And look, very, very close, wasn't it, those margins? I'm not convinced. Look, I'm mostly a big real whacker fan. And I could certainly think he could be a dark horse for the likes of the Gold Cup this year. I think that horse can continue to progress. I think the form isn't bad. But for me, I'm going to side with Envoi Allen. He's the course and distance winner. I think Conflated on a little bit of a recovery mission. Obviously, he was one of the eye catchers last season from the Cheltenham Festival for me, but then disappointed at Aintree when he was pulled up, and obviously has to reverse the form with Minella Indo, was beaten 19.5 lengths. Look, would it be absolutely shocked if Conflated went on and won the race? No, but for me, I think at the prices, 5-1 with our sponsors, Boylesports, I think Envoi Allen is the player. Rachel Blackmore on board, I think it might just get the better of its stablemate, Minella Indo, and Gerry Cologne, obviously, first run of the season. We've seen McGordon as well coming to this race in the past. Sometimes the likes of Conflated went into this race before, well fancied. Obviously, Delta Work as well. Potentially might need the run running.
Who's that, Delta Work?
No, Gordon Elliott's Gerry Cologne.
Of course, Delta Works not weren't running, but Gerry Cologne potentially might need the run. Like, he's not going to be full pelt, is he, at this point? Like, why?
Well, what I was saying was that obviously Conflated went for the race well fancy before, big as a bull. So too was Delta Work. Gordon won't, I'd say he'll be leaving plenty to work with, is the point I'm making.
Yeah, of course. I agree with you completely. I mean, but he still could be classy enough to win, you know, whatever he is, 80, 85%. where Gordon wants him to be at this point, but he'd be madness to have him at full pelt now when the Gold Cup is obviously the senior or the absolute central objective for the season. So there is a scenario where he is not at his best or not at his absolute peak fitness, and he still wins because he's that classy. But Conflated, as you said, ran in this race last year, ran quite well, third, first time up. This time he's had a run, and that just makes him a bit more interesting for me.
The dog is obviously a Jerry Kalam fan anyway. He's not too impressed with saying that the Jerry Kalam will have to come on for the run. I can hear him barking in the background. But let's move on. We're going to move backwards in time, because the 145 at Down Royal is a listed handicap hurdle over 2 miles and one furlong. A race that I absolutely love every single year. I think Thomas Coy went very close a couple of seasons ago when he tipped up, of course, Golden Jewel for Eddie Cawley. But it's a competitive race as always. Some decent sorts in here. What did you make of it?
I think that if there's one that could be thrown in here, and I think it could be Henry's filly here or Mare, Foxy Girl. What do you think? I think like
Snap.
Yeah, I mean, 1, 2, 3. like she could be thrown in. I think, you look at her season last year, she started off, she was second to Liberty Dance. She's a good mare, won at Turles. I think that was Davy's last race, wasn't it? Or supposed last race before he came back. Then she went down and won at Limerick. And then she went off 13-2 off the back of just those two runs, just a maiden hurdle win at Limerick. She went off 13-2 for the Mayor's Novices hurdle. So someone, or a lot of people, thought that she could be a lot better than her rating of 127 in Britain there. And she ran, like, she pulled pretty hard there. She done what any kind of mare you would think, having her third run at Cheltenham Festival, the white hot heat of a Cheltenham Festival, would do. She pulled hard, got a bit excited early on, and just didn't see the race out. Finished eighth, not disgraced at all. But I'm sure they're thinking come back here now for graded races, back to mare's graded races. But they just looked at the mark and thought, geez, 1, 2, 3. Let's have a crack at that, you know. So start off in a good handicap hurdle and see where it goes. She got the hood on first time. There was a couple in here that were interesting, like Palace Rock, thought was interesting. Come back over hurdles, had a nice little warm-up on the flat at Dundalk. But I just keep coming back to her, Foxy Girl. I think she could be thrown in off 1, 2, 3.
The Irish handicapper now has given her 1, 2, 3, as you mentioned, which I think the big thing to mention is that all her form is on soft ground. She's very lightly raced, unexposed, obviously, and they've reached for the headgear. Henry De Bromhead is stable. Just to mention, he's almost trained half the amount of winners that he did last season. Obviously, had two brilliant seasons last year. Maybe a little bit disappointed by Henry's own high standards, but his form, his stable form, 20%, over 20% strike rate, 23 to be correct. And I think Foxy Girl with the hood on for the first time. And obviously, connections will be up there in their finery, looking ahead to Jerry Kalama, the big race. So Foxy Girl could give them a winner before the big race. Have to agree. Anything else to mention on this race?
Nothing on that race, but
Francis Casey has two in here. Love Francis. Has very
Palace Rock and Max Flamingo. And Palace Rock, I think, has a chance, as I said. I will give a quick mention for the card in general, if you have a second. Disappointing turnout for the grade two, only three horses showing up there. But I think Visionarian is interesting. I think the other two might have bigger targets, to especially Farinelli down the line might just be, Emmett might just be thinking of something mad with him like he did last season. But Visionarian comes here in great form for Peter Fahey. Keith Donoghue obviously riding very well. And nearly snuck two grade one on two occasions last season. So I think he might be able to take advantage of a three-runner race. And I think the soft ground might just catch out AINTREE Meadow. He was an on-runner in the Kerry National on account of soft ground. And I'd say Gordon's just running him here with... He's looking at just two other runners. He's got a run, really, but the soft ground might just catch him out. So have a look at Visionarian. And then the handicap chase there, the 3 mile handicap chase, Archie's Charm. He was second in this race last season to Final Orders. And the Final Orders is a really, really in-form horse at the time. And he went on and won again. So he's a well-handicapped horse. And Archie's Charm was just £2 higher now and has had a nice little pipe opener as well at Gowran. I think he'll go very well in the 328 there, the Advanced Sec handicap chase.
We've got new partners. Maybe we could get some sponsor to give us a muzzle for that dog in the background. It's absolutely not happy whatsoever ever since your comments about Jerry Calam and not going well fresh. But anyway, just to mention, by the way, we did have Francis Casey on the podcast. Palace Rock definitely worth another mention because obviously has had the pipe opener at Dundalk. One off 125 at Naas in a really competitive handicap hurdle back in early, of course, of last season off 125. And we had Francis on the show. He did mention that obviously the horse had been struggling and had been to the chiropractor. But if he gets this horse right, he reckoned this horse is going to be a real, real star. Has had the pipe opener, just touched off at Dundalk over a mile and 4 furlongs. And I think definitely should be considered in that competitive handicap at 145. The Haslam Hotel handicap hurdle listed contest and does have Thomas Riley taking off £7. So could be an interesting runner. But I think for win purposes, Foxy Girl for me, followed home by Palace Rock. I think we'll run a fine race for Francis Casey. Right, Sir Ronan, we're going to move on to what is, of course, the race three on the card, which is the Boylesports Grand Sefton Class 2 Chase, 2:45 at Aintree. The card, of course, proudly sponsored by Boylesports. We'll move on to that after we hear from Henry De Bromhead about his chances at Down Royal and mention for one or two stable stars looking ahead to the National Hunt season. So delighted to be joined by Henry De Bromhead on the Champ.ie podcast, looking ahead to what's a busy National Hunt season coming up. We're starting with Down Royal, of course, Henry, this weekend, and the stable going well, 40 winners so far, and well over 20% strike rate.
Yeah, no, we're very happy at the moment. Thankfully, they're all seem to be running well, the majority of them, and yeah, long may it continue.
Super. Let's start with Down Royal, of course, on Friday, Henry. And a couple of entries there to note. Obviously, Magical Zoe, she was very, very unlucky last year in the Mayor's Novice Hurdle at Cheltenham. And I'm sure you're expecting big things from her this year.
Yeah, we're hoping. She won well in Gowran. She should hopefully improve for that. She's in good form. And yeah, looking forward to a good run.
Birdie or Bust is a horse obviously entered in the Grade 3 Mayor's Hurdle, expecting big run.
Yeah, hoping she'll run well. She's in good form. She ran nicely in Tipperary. Obviously, the mare that beat her there is in the race, but we're getting a bit of weight this time. But yeah, she's in good form and hoping for a good run.
Just in relation to Magical Zoe, just before moving on, Henry, about her. Obviously, she won at Down Royal last season. She was a big price. Obviously, she was very inexperienced coming into the race. She clearly likes the course. Are you expecting her to go very close tomorrow?
Look, I hope she'll run well. It's a good race. You know, on ratings, she's got a good chance. And we're happy with her. So we'll see. Yeah, look, she's in good form. And yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed.
Do you think she could go to the very top this year in the mare division?
Yeah, look, as I say, she's a nice mare. We need to see, can she get stay 2.5? We only tried once last year, but it probably wasn't the right time. It was only a couple of weeks after Cheltenham in the mare's Grade 1 at Ferry House. So, but if she stays, she could, yeah.
Super. On to Saturday, Slade Steel was a horse that made a big impression in a bumper last season, of course, and ran into what's a good sort in Ballyburn as well later in the season.
Yeah, he's a nice horse. We've always liked him. As you say, he won his bumper well. He ran well in Punchestown. Look, he won his point to point. He schools well. We hope he's going to be a nice horse for the season, yeah.
Over hurdles, is he one that I suppose you'd be targeting at all the big Grade 1 races later in the spring?
Well, if they have to box their way up there, you know, but we hope he could develop into a graded horse. So he'll start in a maiden hurdle, and you know, we know what these maiden hurdles are like at this time of year, so you have to try and win one of those first, and then we'll see. You know, once if we hopefully we will do that and we can box our way up from there.
Super. In the same silks, obviously, Foxy Girl is entered up in the handicap listed. Do you think she can be competitive off her mark?
I hope so. She's a nice mare. She won well at Limerick last year. She was a bit disappointing in the mare's hurdle. She's big mare though, and I'd say maybe everything just caught up on her a bit. But She's working well there now, and we're hoping for a nice run.
Super. On to the big race, of course. Obviously, Envoi Allen, winner of the race last season, and went on, of course, to big things as well, winning the Ryanair Chase last season at the Cheltenham Festival.
Yeah, he's in good form. He was a bit disappointing in Gowran. I think the ground was a bit heavy for him, but it was good to get the run. And he seems in good form. And again, we're hoping for a good run, so long as the ground doesn't get too soft. You know, he won the race last year. I'd say he's probably more a 2.5 to 3 mile horse, as he showed in the Ryanair, than a sort of 3+. So look, this he has course and distance form, so it seems silly not to have a go.
Obviously, looking ahead to the season, In the Pocket was won very well, of course, last season at Aintree towards the back end of the season. Is he a horse that you've high hopes for this year?
Yeah, we do. Yeah, he's a lovely horse. Touchwood, he's been schooling well, and he will go for the 2 mile beginners chase at Navan next weekend.
Boylesports, don't just bet, choose wisely.
So we are back, Ronan Groome, to talk about the feature at Aintree. Of course, they are inspecting early in the morning on Saturday. The Grand Sefton is the feature race on the card, and over the 2 mile, 5 furlongs, over the national fences. If it goes ahead, it's going to be a spectacle.
Yeah, always good to see them over the national fences. Probably a smaller field than recent renewals, but maybe that is a count on the heavy ground. Jess Hill is obviously your market leader there, with the good sponsors, a bit of a standing dish at the course. Got that course and distance form. The heavy ground is the main thing here, isn't it, really? I was going through a few of these and putting a line through them straight away. The one that kind of landed down on, and it's interesting to see the sponsors, Boyles here, have ducked him a bit at 6-1, Nassalam for Gary Moore. I just think he's interesting. I think, like, there's always been the feeling this horse has a good race in him, and he does have a lot of wins and a lot of seconds to his name, but maybe just hasn't landed that big race yet. And I think that's on account of him being coming through the juvenile hurdle ranks and being quite young, going chasing as a 5-year-old last season. But if you look at his third to Midnight River over the 2.5 at Cheltenham there on New Year's Day, I think that's a really good run. Obviously, Midnight River has gone on to be quite a good horse, and Il Redotto was fourth that day, went on to win a 2.5 at Cheltenham as well. I thought that was a really good run from Nassalam. Didn't stay, I think, over the 3 miles. So come back to 2.5, he's got a reasonable record fresh, and he's got a reasonable record on soft ground as well. So I think he could be reasonably handicapped off 142. Quaylen Quinn is taking the £5 off. And just as I said, interesting to see Boyles have ducked him a bit. You can get bigger with other bookmakers out there, so maybe take the hint. But the good traders at Boyles are keeping this fella on side, and I like him as well.
Yeah, one of my best fancies of the weekend in terms of each way bets is one of my old friends, Ronan Groome. And I think if I thought it was well treated off 136 last year, then off 133 on heavy ground in a race like this, Ferrero Bamboo for a yard that can be streaky. Let's face it, Phoenicia Williams, the stable form at the moment, well, it's in her favour because it's 27% for the trainer in terms of her strike rate at the moment. So stable, very much in form. And we know when they are.
Big winner on Saturday.
Yeah, exactly. So for me, I was just hoping to see this horse at 2.5 miles for a long period last season. And I thought it was well treated. Arguably its best run last year came over 2-1 on its first start of the season when going fresh at Ascot. And obviously was beaten 4 lengths by Time White, but came tumbling down the ratings. Obviously, well, the guts of now you can make it that it has come down officially £9 since that run. So over 2.5 miles, I think there's not a whole pile of pace in the race. I could see this horse being ridden quite handy. It's versatile in terms of the way it's likely to be ridden. But Charlie Deutsch on board, number 7, nice racing weight. I hope it does go ahead. I hope the heavy ground stays, because I do remember, Ronan, you might remember that day where there was torrential rain that Energamine won his first champion chase. Well, on the same card, Ferrero Bamboo, of course, was absolutely smashed in the 6-1. Finished third in the Grand Annual, but heavy ground, I think, will definitely suit. And at 12-1, you're getting a double figure price. I think it's a knocking each way bet.
Yeah, I backed him before. I can't remember. I backed him for the Grand Annual 2 seasons back, I think. And he ran well there. So, yeah, I like that. I like the soft ground angle with him. Yeah. And Venetia, obviously, in great form.
Yeah, so I thought there was lots to like about that. Ronan, let's rattle on, and we're going to move to Wincanton now. And we have to mention, first of all, we'll mention the Badger Beers. So race number four on the five cast. Make sure you're getting your selections down below. The Badger Beers, Mike Vince loves this race. He's not on this week to tell us what will win it, though. So we're left with you, Ronan.
Yeah, left with me, I'm quite fond of the race as well. It's the old Badger Beers. It's right to start the season and backed a couple of winners in it before. I always associated with Paul Nicholls. I think he targets this race especially, and it looks the case this season. Hold on, and 3 under 5, both vying for favouritism. Frodon is perennially interesting, isn't he? He's back here off a mark of 158, which he won the race off last season. And there's no reason to suggest that he might be as good again with Bryony Frost in the place. He just seems to be a horse that will never, ever go away. He's only 11 now, and I can make a case for him again. 3 under 5 is obviously interesting with Harry Cobden on board. I think he has a bit more to give off a mark of 147. But the one I actually went for in the end is Sam Brown for Anthony Honeyball, and our old friend of the podcast, Johnny Burke, riding quite well these days also, off a mark of 152. I just thought he was interesting. You go back to his seasonal debut last year, he was third in the Charlie Hall, the Brave Man's Game, so it was a huge effort first time up. He was rated 157 then. He's 152 now, and I don't think he's done a lot wrong since. If you go back to his last run, he fell at Punchestown. I think he was leading at the second last that day. That was the a carnage race towards the end. I think there was a lot of fallers and stuff, but he was about to run really well there, and he has run well at Punchestown before. And I think Anthony Honeyball might look at this race and thought, yeah, let's get him going first time out here. And I see boys have got 9-1 price by him. I think that's quite big, and I'll be taking some of that each way on the day.
I think Ballygriffin Cottage is a horse that we must mention. Obviously has had its problems. They've reached for the tongue strap. He's had a wind operation on two occasions for the Skelton team. The big breakaway. Some fine names in here at the top of the market with Boylesports, Frodon, as you mentioned. But the one for me that I do think is interesting, it's the mount of Harry Cobden. It's a joint favourite now, should I say, with the good sponsors, Boylesports. I'm going to side with 3 under 5. I don't think it's a horse, Ronan, that we've seen the best of. Likely races, only had 10 runs, 4 wins over the fences from 10 starts, should I say. And it's only £2 higher over fences than his hurdles mark of 145. Now, if you were to say that to Paul Nicholls at the end of his hurdle career, that this horse will only achieve a rating of 147, I'm not sure whether he would have been surprised. Surely he would have been surprised. So for me, I think certainly has to have a squeak. He's had wind surgery and in the past has run well when coming back off an absence. So after wind surgery off 147 for the Nicholls and Cobden combination, that'll do for me. 20% for the Paul Nicholls stable in terms of their strike rate. So I got to go with 3 under 5, not going to complicate it. They won the race last season, of course. Fantastic record in the race in the Badger Beers. So going to side with 3 under 5 for the McNeils. The Rising Stars novice Chase Ronan, what wins it this year?
Nabbers Hill should win it, Basil. I'd be disappointed if he didn't. If Captain Combi can go over and beat Nabbers Hill now, I think we might as well just call off the whole the jump season from the British perspective anyway. I'm not saying Captain Combi isn't a useful animal. He is. I've backed him before. I think I backed him in the Coral Cup last season, actually, and he is a decent animal, but I think he was pretty much put in his place the last day by Sharjah. And I think Nabbers Hill, very good win record, actually, over hurdles. He won 7 times from 13 starts over hurdles. Probably just below the top grade, maybe that sort of grade 2 level, that kind of elite hurdle level, I suppose, that race at Wincanton. And I think he might want to go this way as well. He might want to go right-handed. I know he has won left-handed before, but he hung a bit the last day. Still a good run against a useful horse and unexpected party, and they pulled clear. He should come on for that pretty wise. And as I said, I think Connections would be very disappointed now if he didn't get it done here.
I like Captain Combi, I must say, and as a horse that I wouldn't be surprised if ran a big race here as well, especially given the ground conditions on its day. Gavega Obviously came from the Colin Bow Academy, and a horse that they talk quite a lot of, has had a start over fences as of yet. 3 wins from 5 over hurdles, and said with the twice he didn't win running, he was pulled up. So on his day, very much on the day, I think Gavega could give a big running for the Moors, but I think the obvious one here for 5 cast purposes, Ronan, would be Nappers Hill, based on his ratings over hurdles. If you can translate that, looks the one to beat for sure. Right, set, Ronan, we are going to take a little ad break, and when we come back, we're going to talk best bets for the weekend, and set, we're going to gear up towards next week as well with some cracking shows lined up.
Gowran Park Racecourse, the premier racetrack in the southeast of Ireland, is located on the outskirts of Kilkenny City. Gowran is your number one choice for corporate days out, stag and hen party events, and an overall great local racing experience. Known as the race that stops the county, the famous Goffs Thyestes Chase 2024 takes place on Thursday the 25th of January.
In the finish of the Goffs Thyestes, invitation only, and Ruby Walsh on the near side for Willie Mullen's 7th win of the race. Invitation only has beaten Alphinus Opus.
With packed crowds expected once again this January, you can book your early bird tickets online today. Visit gowranpark.ie online, click the link in the Champ.ie podcast video description, or scan the QR code on screen to purchase right now. Eddie and the team look forward to welcoming you all to Gowran Park Racecourse this winter.
Yes, and important to scan the QR code, get your early bird tickets for Thyestes Day, of course, 25th of January, and the Red Mills Chase Day, of course, the 17th, Saturday the 17th of February, and Shamrock Chase Day on the eve of the Cheltenham Festival. 3 cracking days rolling, and we look forward to some Morning Line live shows on course. Look forward to seeing you all there. Right, so Ronan, let's play the 5 cast. It's up on screen as we speak. Get your selections down below, of course, to be in with a chance of getting yourself into that monthly VIP prize draw, which this month, of course, November, we will be drawing the winner on the 30th of November. It includes a Boylesports free bet and some other goodies. Right, Ronan, selection 1. We're going to start with the champion chase. Nail your colours to the mask, please.
Going to take a chance on Conflated. Jerry Colomb, long term, I think he's going to be a huge player in the Gold Cup this year, but I think Conflated could have his day on Saturday.
Got to go with my old friend Envoi Allen. Right, the listed handicap hurdle, 145. I think we're in agreement, Ronan. Foxy Girl for me.
Yeah, all over the Foxy Girl.
In that 145 at Down Royal. The Grand Sefton, I'm going with Frero Bamboo. Fingers crossed that goes ahead.
Yes, fingers crossed goes ahead, and I'll take Nassalam.
Nassalam for Ronan. Right, the Badger Beers. Who are you going with?
All on Sam Brown. I like him a lot, actually. Yeah, Sam Brown.
3 under true 5 for me, Ronan. Going to go with the McNeils on this one. And I'm going to side with Nappers Hill to complete the 5 cast.
Yes, I'm with you on Nappers Hill. I think he should win well.
Right, the County Kilkenny GA Day is at Gowran Park this weekend, this Saturday. Get yourself down there, of course, if you're local or you fancy travelling for a fantastic meeting. Always a big race down there. Of course, we've seen Fernie Hollow winning the race in the past. Of course, Bob Bollinger, that was some race, wasn't it? What are we expecting at Gowran this weekend? Anything stick out for you, Ron?
Well, of course, Brandy Love is back in the first there, the Beginner's Chase, making her debut. So that's quite interesting to see how she gets on. I haven't had a good look at the card yet, Basil. But as you say, it should be a lot of interest in action, a lot of decent maiden hurdles where you could see a nice horse. And always good racing at Gowran.
Yes, just a couple that have flashed up in the tracker at Gowran, just to mention. Obviously, Il Atlantique also entered up at Gowran. I think that's a horse that we could be hearing a lot more about this season for the Willie Mullins.
Do you actually? Because I like the horse that beat him in the bumper there at Fairy House. It was a Fairy House, the Fire Fox. For the Morans and Gornella, he's on my shortlist here for our old horses to follow season when we do that on Monday. So that's interesting. You like the Il Atlantique? It's probably the old Nergamine colours that's tracking you in there.
Well, we won't discuss that on certainly on this episode. Obviously, Sco Scottish as well is a horse that is entered up as well at 12:53 in that handicap chase. And well, if that was to be the day for local trainer Emmett Mullins, that could certainly be of interest as well. It was many people shortlisted, of course, for the plate at the Cheltenham Festival last season, but a cracking day in store. And just some names to note ahead of that card. A County Kilkenny GAA Day at Gowran Park this weekend. Right, Ronan, best bets of the weekend. The floor is yours, and I want a nap at the end.
Best bets are like Archie's charm at Down Royal, as I mentioned, in the 3 mile the 3 mile handicap chase there. And I do like my nap is going to be the Foxy Girl. I think she's very attractively handicapped off a mark of 123. So I'm writing these headlines as I speak. You might see that in the Irish Reel tomorrow. So the Foxy Girl for me off 123. Very interesting to see how they price her up, but I think she's going to take a world of beating.
Well, I'm praying that obviously the Grand Sefton goes ahead and AINTREE on the national course all as well there. And I'm going up for an each way bet. Definitely Freira Bamboo has to go into the mix. And for me, I'm very excited to see how Magical Zoe gets on Friday. Obviously, we're recording on Thursday. That's a horse, obviously, priced up at 2-1 with the sponsors for Henry De Bromhead. I thought it was a major eye catcher. And everyone thought the same, I suppose, in that Mayor's Novice Hurdle last season. Held up off the pace, won at the meeting last year, and in against the geldings, getting weight. I think she's a cracking price at 2-1. And it's going to be an exciting jump season. There is a novice handicap chase on the card, of course, at AINTREE. It's always a cracking race. It's at 1 o'clock on Saturday as well. And I thought Giovinco was a horse that was absolutely cantering when coming down last time, off its mark of 143 for Lucinda Russell, and Stephen McQueen is jocked up. It's a competitive handicap. There is five of them, but you could make a case for any of the five. That's a horse I think Ronan can go quite far this season. Giovinco, and also will be putting him in to my bet slips this weekend with our, of course, good sponsors, Boylesports. But Ronan, pleasure. Great to be back. Great to hear from Henry De Bromhead. Great to have, obviously, Syndicates Racing and Gowran Park as new partners for the year. And super to have Boyles on board, Boylesports on board once again, looking ahead to the new season. And you need to get your thinking cap on now, because we need your first AntePost selection on Monday for the Road to Cheltenham Challenge. We look forward to having Jack Cantle on, hopefully on next weekend, looking ahead to the November meeting, plus some special guests at Cheltenham. But it's going to be an exciting season, Ronan. Anything else to mention before we close up?
No, just a great weekend of action. Looking forward to seeing Jerry Clum, how he gets on. I really do like the horse, and I've backed him already for the Gold Cup. Very much looking forward to seeing how he gets on, even though I made a case for Conflated there. But I'd love to see Jerry go and win handsomely and get the season off to a flyer. And obviously looking forward to the action as well. Everywhere, Gowran Park, AINTREE, Wincanton, we're really in full flow now. So it's great.
And we'll see you on Monday.